Hi guys, and welcome to our second quiz game. Let's start our quiz. Okay, let's see the first question in this quiz. Which of the following is the current HTML standard? You remember we talked about this one. The current version of HTML is HTML5. So this should be the right answer. And yes, it is correct. Let's continue. Which of the following is the correct syntax for a comment in HTML? And let's see. We have the double forward slash. We have the hashtag character. And then we have the correct syntax for a comments in HTML, and it is the left angle bracket, the exclamation point, dash dash, and then you put the content of the comment inside, and then dash dash right angle bracket. This one is similar to this correct one, but it is missing the exclamation point here. So this is the right answer. Yeah, of course, let's continue. The following code creates a link to another page. Which of the following will cause the page to open in a new browser window? You remember this? We talked about a specific HTML attribute that we use if we want to open a new browser window when we click on a link, on a HTML link, and that attribute is called target attribute. Let's see the answers. Single quotation marks should be used instead of double quotation marks. Wrap the A tag with a window tag. So the first is false, the second is false. Add the target attribute with its value set to underscore blank. This one is correct, and the last one, the URL should include new underscore window at the end of it. It is false, of course, so let's select this one. Yeah, it's correct. Let's continue to the next question. The following code is supposed to create a link to another web page, but fails to do so. Why? We have the link element, but we are missing the href attribute. Let's see. The A element should be replaced with a link element. False. The word Codecademy should be replaced with the URL to the Codecademy website. False. The A tag, closing tag, should be removed. It is also false. And here is the correct answer. The A element is missing the href attribute set to the URL of the Codecademy website, and let's select this one. It is correct, of course. Let's continue. All HTML code must be nested within which of the following tags? You remember this one? We talked about HTML tag. Everything should be placed inside of the opening HTML and closing HTML tags. Let's select this one, and it is correct, of course. Let's proceed. Which of the following would create a link to a local HTML file called aboutme.html? Let's see. We have the A element, href, HTTPS. Then we have the second one, the third one, and the last one. You remember this one? So this should be the right answer. We have the opening A tag, we have the closing A tag, we have the content between those tags, and we have the href attribute and its value set to dash forward slash aboutme.html. This is how we create a link to a local HTML file. This is also called a relative path. Let's click this one. Yes, it is correct, of course. Let's proceed. What is the purpose of indentation and whitespace? To make sure the browser correctly interprets nested elements in an HTML file, false. To make code in an HTML file more readable, this should be correct. To change the display of elements in the browser, false. To comment out code you don't need, false. Let's select this one. And it is correct, of course. Let's proceed. Which of the following elements contains a web page's metadata? You remember we talked about this one. All HTML elements that are related to page's metadata should be placed between the head tags, the opening head tag and the closing head tag. And it is correct, of course. Let's proceed. The contents of the title tag will appear where in a modern browser? You remember this one? It should appear in a little tab of your page. Let's see, the last line of the web page, false. It does not appear anywhere, false. The browser's tab, this is the correct answer. And we have the first line of the web page, also false. Let's select this one. It is correct, of course. Let's proceed. Which of the following tags instructs the browser to expect a well-formed HTML document? You remember this one? We talked about special line of code that we should place in every HTML document at the beginning of that HTML document on the first line. It should be this one. Let's click. And of course it is correct. Let's proceed. Why should the document type declaration be included in all HTML documents? Let's see the answers. To specify the HTML standard being used in the content, this looks like it is correct. Without it, any HTML code is invalid. To specify what content it is in the browser, without it, the web page will not be allowed on the internet. Like I said, this is the correct answer. Yep, let's proceed. The following HTML code should only exist within which of the following tags? Do you remember where we should place the title element, the title HTML element? It should be placed between the head tags. So let's select the head tag. And it is also correct. And this should be all for this quiz. We completed all the questions with the maximum result. Yeah, quiz scorecard says we have the 100% points. So great job. Everything is correct. And we have the pop-up message saying, well done, great job finishing that quiz. Keep going. The next section in our series on web development should be our first project called Fashion Blog. Okay, see you guys in the next section where we should build the fashion blog.